In an era plagued by yellow journalism and fake news, readers want access to credible news now more than ever, and they're willing to pay for it. Reading multiple newspapers requires multiple expensive subscriptions. Currently, readers are not able to share and freely consume content, an obvious demand in our age of digital interconnectivity. Subscribers pay for all of a publisher's content, that which they read as well as the content that they don't. Noozit's cross-platform payment system gives readers an inexpensive way to read high-quality journalism from a variety of publishers. At the same time, publishers retain full control over their content and advertising revenue streams. Welcome to Noozit, the new way to news.
So my name is Evan Turner, and I am a co-founder of Noozit. At the moment, the news industry fails to convert 99% of their readers into paying customers. And there are three reasons why. First of all, if someone wants access to media from a multiple different publishers, they need to pay for the subscription fees of each and every one of them. When you add up the New York Times, the Washington Post, and the Chicago Tribune, this adds up and can get incredibly expensive, delivering a poor value. Secondly, when you subscribe to a news organization, you're paying for a bunch of articles that you do want to read, as well as a lot of articles that you don't want to read. This incurs an excess of overhead. Now, lastly, let's say I want to share an article of the Financial Times with my mother. If she doesn't have her own subscription, she can't read that article, making the system overall less accessible. So through our customer discovery, we have identified two customer archetypes. At the B2C level, we have identified Savvy Sarah. Every week, she needs to read the news in order to stay current and make informed decisions for her job. But unfortunately, every time she reads the 5 or 10 free articles that are given to her, she's stopped by an expensive paywall, and she can't access the information that she needs. At the business-to-business level, we have Executive Earl. He works in the circulation department of a news organization. He would love nothing more than access to an entirely new revenue stream from the conversion of casual readers like Savvy Sarah into paying customers. To solve this, Noozit has created a cross-platform payment system that would allow users to acquire content at a per-article rate. At the business level, we offer an integration process that can run in less than 50 lines of code. Our business model operates by giving 70% of revenues per article back to the original publisher. Noozit takes a 30% commission. Now, Noozit has 4 enormous competitive advantages. First of all, our elastic paywall allows users to get that content at the per article rate without a big upfront charge. Secondly, Noozit enables publisher control. In the news industry, companies get about 50%, give or take, of their overall revenue from advertisements. Unlike the majority of our competitors, Noozit keeps the content on their platform, so we don't infringe on any of this revenue. Thirdly, Noozit provides up-to-date content. Some of our competitors operate by scanning physically printed copies of newspaper. The problem here is by the time this content gets to the reader, it can be up to a whole day late. By having our content on the original platform, it's available as soon as the article is published. Lastly, Noozit has inherent exposure. By integrating with the websites of these news companies, we are able to harness the already existent mass web traffic that exists on their platform. So let me get you up to date on where Noozit is today. After the inception of our idea in August, we were accepted into eLab in September. Between the months of September and March, we conducted over 100 consumer interviews. Through this, we were able to develop the perfect solution to this problem. Last month, we finished our minimum viable products. We've been in contact with 4 major news organizations, and in the months to come, we plan on following up with them and expanding upon this in order to run trials and get feedback. So allow me to introduce you to the team that has made this happen. As I said before, my name is Evan Turner, and working on the technology side, we have Baron Dubois, Sky Richardson, and Constantine Miranda, all very talented individuals. So why now? In an era that is so clearly plagued by yellow journalism, it is more important now than ever to provide readers with credible content, and they are willing to pay for it. In fact, in the past few years, the number of people subscribing to digital news has done nothing but increase. If you look at other types of consumer media, like TV, movies, music, all of these things have been consolidated and distributed by successful tech giants like Netflix, Hulu, and Spotify. These organizations have set the precedent for a clear paradigm shift from single publisher media sources to content delivery facilitators. It is inevitable that this change will extend to the news industry as well, and we will be that facilitator. So why are we here today? We have two big asks. We would love introductions to people who work in the circulation departments of news organizations, as well as those who generally know the ins and outs of the news industry. In the top corner here, you can see my contact information. So if you want to get in touch, feel free to write it down, take a picture, and get in touch. Thank you all for your time and attention today, and have a great day.